Hi everyone, this is Professor Mansoo Han at Mokpo National University. My topic is Dynamic Bandwidth Allocation Method of XGS-PON System using Time Sliding Window Traffic Prediction. In this paper, we propose a new dynamic bandwidth allocation method for XGS-PON or 10 gigabit per second capable symmetric passive optical network. After the first dynamic bandwidth allocation with the current buffer length, the second dynamic bandwidth allocation is performed with the remaining bandwidth and predicted buffer length. For the buffer length prediction, the amount of arrival packets during a unit time is used. Using computer simulation, we compare the mean delay and delay variance values of the proposed method with those of other existing methods. The XGS-PON system consists of one OLT and n ONUs to support multiple service classes, and ONU has a buffer for each service class. The service class is called TCONT or traffic container type in the XGS-PON system. In this paper, only TCONT types 2, 3, and 4 are considered. TCONT type 2 is assured traffic in which transmission bandwidth allocation is guaranteed, and TCONT type 3 is non-assured traffic in which transmission bandwidth allocation is not guaranteed. TCONT type 4 is best effort traffic. The slide figure shows the XGS-PON system. Rn is the unique bandwidth of the ONU, and Ru is the user input bandwidth of the ONU. Buffer Qij of ONU indicates a buffer in which packets of TCONT type J in ONU are stored. When transmitting a packet downlink from OLT to ONU, the packet is transmitted in a broadcasting manner through a splitter. The ONU receives a downlink packet and discards the packet if the packet's destination is not the ONU itself. When transmitting a packet from an ONU to the OLT, the unique bandwidth Rn is shared by all ONUs. So the unique bandwidth used by each ONU in a time division manner. Therefore, only one ONU can use the unique bandwidth at a time. The OLT receives a request of each buffer from the ONUs, performs dynamic bandwidth allocation or DBA to determine the unique transmission time not to be duplicated for each ONU, and then delivers the result to each ONU. All operations of XGS-PON are synchronized with unit time. In the XGS-PON system, the unit time is fixed at 125 microseconds. OLT executes DBA every unit time, then stores the results in BW map or bandwidth map, and transmit the BW map to each ONU at the end of each unit time. Since all operations are synchronized with the unit time, the sum of the transmission time allocated by the DBA is also less than the unit time. The request sent from ONU to OLT is the sum of the lengths of packets stored in a buffer. The OLT determines and informs the command to send the request for each buffer Qij and the unique transmission time to be used when sending the request. The buffer Qij, which has received the command to send the request, informs the OLT of the total length of the packets stored in it. The more frequently buffer Qij sends requests, the better the OLT can understand the status of each buffer. However, since the unique bandwidth is used when sending the request message, if the request message is frequently sent, the omnic bandwidth may be wasted. In this paper, it is assumed that the request sending period is different for each service class. The OLT can demand a request to an ONU. At this time, a separated omnic bandwidth for the request is allocated so that the ONU can send the request information to the OLT. This separated omnic bandwidth is called DBRU or dynamic bandwidth allocation upstream. In general, the buffer QIJ sends the total length of the stored packet using DBRU. However, in this paper, it is assumed that the buffer QIJ manages the amount of newly arrived packet for each unit time. And when DBRU is allocated, the newly arrived packet amount is transmitted to the OLT using the DBRU. In this paper, the service interval of the buffer QIJ is called SIJ. Also, the available amount of service that can be received during SIJ is called VIJ. Also, the OLT stores the buffer length of QIJ and the buffer length of the buffer QIJ at unit time T is called NIJT. Also, the sum of the lengths of packets newly arrived at QIJ during unit time T is called AIJT. Let the grant GIJT be the transmission amount that the OLT allows to the buffer QIJ at the unit time T. Then the buffer length of the buffer QIJ at the next unit time T plus one is given by equation one. In equation one, we can see NIJT plus one equals NIJT plus AIJT minus GIJT. On the other hand, it takes time and the BW map in which the DBA result is stored is transmitted from the OLT to each ONU, and if the distance between the OLT and the ONU is 20 kilometers, the time is 100 microseconds. Also, ONU needs about 30 microseconds preparation time after receiving the BW map. Therefore, when the grant GIJT arrives at QIJ, more than one unit time has already elapsed. So there are new packets AIJT plus one in QIJ. Since the new packet length AIJT plus one cannot be known at unit time T, it cannot be directly reflected in DBA at unit time T. In this paper, we propose a method for predicting the new arrival packet length and using this predicted packet length for DBA. In this paper, the TSW or time sliding window prediction method is modified. The TSW method is a method of calculating the average arrival rate of the next packet whenever a packet arrives. The slide figure shows the TSW algorithm. Since the XGS point system is synchronized with a unit time of 125 microseconds, the TSW method is modified to calculate the average amount of arrival packets in unit time. Let EIJT be the average amount of arrived packets of the buffer QIJ at unit time T. Then at unit time T plus one, we obtain the equation two. In the equation two, EIJT plus one equals EIJT times average interval plus AIJT divided by one plus AVG intervals. In the equation two, AVG interval has a unit of 125 microseconds. That is, if AVG interval equals 10, it means 10 times 125 microseconds. Also, it is assumed that EIJ zero equals zero, which is the initial value of EIJT. In this paper, DBA is first executed using the buffer length NIJT, and then DBA is additionally executed using the remaining service amount VIJ and EIJT plus one. If the total upstream bandwidth of the XGS PON system is F, the pulse stage DBA algorithm using the buffer length NIJT is shown in this slide. The grant GIJT is determined as the minimum value among VIJ, NIJT, and F, and each VIJ, NIJT, and F are reduced by the grant GIJT. This slide shows the DBA algorithm of the second stage using the predicted packet arrival rate EIJ T plus one. The variable G means the additional grant. The variable G is calculated as the minimum value of VIJ, EIJ T plus one, and F. Then VIJ and F are each reduced by G, and G is added to the grant GIJT that is calculated in the first stage DBA. After DBA, timer TIJ decreases by one, and if TIJ equals zero, VIJ is recharged with BIJ, and TIJ is recharged with SIJ. Here, BIJ is the maximum service amount that buffer QIJ can receive during SIJ. The VIJ recharge algorithm is shown in this slide. In this paper, during the second stage DBA, additional transmission bandwidth is allocated using the remaining VIJ after performing the first stage DBA. If SIJ is greater than or equal to 2, bandwidth loss may occur in the DBA of the next unit time due to the second stage DBA in the current unit time. For example, when SIJ equals 2 and unit time T, suppose that EIJ T plus 1 consumes all VIJ in the second stage DBA. Then even if NIJ T plus 1 is greater than 0 in the first stage DBA and unit time T plus 1, we have GIJ T plus 1 equals 0 since VIJ equals 0 at the previous unit time. The value EIJ T plus 1 cannot be updated since it is a predicted value, resulting in bandwidth wastage. In order to minimize such bandwidth waste in this paper, it is assumed that SIJ of all TCON types 2 and 3 is SIJ equals 1. Also, since TCON type 4 is best depth traffic, the buffer length is not predicted and the second stage DBA is not executed for TCON type 4. Using simulation, the performance of the proposed method is evaluated. Assume that the total number of ONUs n equals 16 and the omnic bandwidth Rn equals 10 gigabps. The maximum user input bandwidth of each ONU is Ru equals 1 gigabps. In addition, the distance between OLT and ONU is 20 kilometers. And the size of each QIJ is 2 megabyte. Also, in the case of TCON types 2 and 3, we set SIJ equals 1. And in the case of TCON type 4, we set SIJ equals 5. For TCON types 2 and 3, we set BIJ equals 4732 bytes. And for TCON type 4, we set BIJ equals 48600. bytes. Therefore, the bandwidth is 302.8 megabits for TCON types 2 and 3 and 622 megabits for TCON type 4. Also, we use the variable AVG interval equals 4. For comparison with other method, first the performance of the proposed method is compared with that of the immediate allocation with colorless grant or IACG method. At this time, the colorless grant part that does not conform to the XGS PON standard in the IACG is not used. As a second comparison method, a commonly used traffic prediction method is used. In the second method, we set EIJT plus 1 equals AIJT, which is applied by assuming that the traffic arrival rates in the current and the next unit times are the same. Let's call the second method the IAA or immediate allocation with aggressive estimation method. The input traffic used in the simulation uses the self-similar traffic. Each ONU receives packet from an on-off traffic generation process that follows the Pareto distribution. The shape variables of the on and off process are 1.4 and 1.2 respectively. In addition, the distribution of packet size uses a trimodal distribution and the occurrence rates are 60%, 20%, and 20% for packet lengths of 64 and 500 and 1,500 bytes respectively. The ratio of traffic for each TCON type assumes balanced traffic. Therefore, the probability that an arrival packet to the ONU is input to the buffer for each TCON type is the same. The performance of each method was evaluated while increasing the input traffic load of each ONU from 0.1 to 0.99. Each simulation was carried out until the number of packets transmitted from ONUs to OLT reached 10 to the 9th. This figure shows the mean packet delay for TCON type 2. And this the mean packet delay for TCON types 3 and 4 are shown in this slide. And this figure shows the packet delay variance for TCON type 2. And this figure shows packet delay variance for TCON types 3 and 4. As shown in each figure, the proposed method is superior to TCON types 2 and 3 in mean delay compared to other methods. In the proposed method, since omnic bandwidth is used more in TCON types 2 and 3, the opportunity to use omnic bandwidth in TCON type 4 is reduced. Therefore, the performance of the TCON type 4 is not good compared to other methods. However, since TCON type 4 is best effort traffic, it is reasonable that TCON types 2 and 3, which have higher priorities, use more omnic bandwidth. In this paper, we proposed the IAT method, which is a new method for DBA of XGS PON using the modified TSW prediction method to predict the amount of arrival packets in the next unit time. First, DBA is performed with only the current buffer length, and then additional DBA is performed with the remaining bandwidth and predicted packet arrival rate. We compare the performance of the proposed method with the performance of a method without packet prediction and with the performance of a method for predicting the packet arrival amount in the next unit time as the packet arrival amount in the current unit time. It was verified that the proposed method was superior in mean delay of the higher service classes compared to other methods. Thank you for watching.